Hello and welcome to the Wishlist, the weekly series where we tell you about all the things we're totally digging. I'm your host, Ashley Escada. When you play most tabletop card games, you're a hero seeking to destroy your enemies via powerful, magical, and physical attacks. But that's not quite how it works in my pick for this week, Gloom, the merrily macabre card game that asks you to do the most damage possible to your own family of characters. The first thing you'll notice about Gloom's packaging is the delightfully dark, Edward Gorey, Tim Burton-esque artwork, which carries throughout the deck. The second thing you'll notice when you open the package is that the cards in Gloom are transparent. They have all kinds of occurrences on them, each with a negative or positive self-worth point value attached. You'll choose a family to play as, and each family comes with 5 delightful, weird family members to manage. The goal of Gloom is to deal the mightiest blows to each of your family members' self-worth, and then kill them off at the height of their misery. If it sounds morbid, that's because it is. The best kind of morbid, like putting the fun in funeral kind of morbid. Of course, there are modifiers and other standard types of cards you see in regular tabletop gaming. If you can't get enough of Gloom or you want to play with more than 4 players, there are actually various expansion packs available, just like you would see in other tabletop games, to expand the horrible happenings and cheery chances. But we're specifically fans of the Unpleasant Dreams pack. It's a Cthulhu-themed deck with all kinds of Lovecraftian-themed cards to shuffle into your game. There's been a huge resurgence of tabletop gaming lately thanks to shows like Tabletop with Will Wheaton and Felicia Day. That's super awesome, and they've already played Gloom on their show, so if you're still not sure, you can check out a full playthrough. But we can confidently say it is amazing, especially if you have a morbid sense of humor like yours truly. So you could pick up Gloom's starter pack on Amazon, but I would bet many tabletop aficionados would encourage you to seek out a local shop in your area in which to spend your weekly scratch. That's the stuff we like this week. Tune in next week to check out all the things that make us swoon. And make sure you email us what's on your wish list, because you might see your favorite stuff featured in a future episode. See you next week.